in an unexplored depth of the ocean.
That describes almost all of it, so you're too specific. Please be more vague. Wherever it is, three villains are plotting naughtiness.
This is the time to combine our genius against a common adversary. You, Black Manta, and you, Vassa, Queen of the Mermen.
And you, Brain.
Yes, and me, the Brain.
Since it's right there in his name, we can assume he's the brains of the operation. He's come up with a three-pronged attack that he's sure will take down Aquaman for good.
While Vassa attacks Aquaman's underwater detection system, you, Manta, will penetrate Atlantis with your new gas globules.
And you?
To myself, I assign the pleasurable task of destroying Aquaman.
Of course he did. That's nothing out of the ordinary. What is unusual is the other two aren't protesting and claiming the privilege for themselves. And neither is asking the obvious question, how does he intend to do that?
That's two stations destroyed, Aquaman.
Could be an all-out attack. Let's go.
Vassa's ship isn't hard to spot since it's shaped like a mechanical whale, but she's ready for them.
Launch tactile torpedoes.
Tactile means you can touch it and feel it. I suppose tactile torpedoes are more effective than intangible torpedoes, but I don't know where you'd even get one of those.
Watch them explode with a touch of a feather.
I guess it's a good thing there aren't too many birds that live on the bottom of the ocean then. Aqualad thinks he's got this and he swims off to redirect the lead torpedo.
No, Aqualad, don't!
Okay, Aquaman, please explain to me how you blowing it up in his face was better than him blowing it up in his own face.
Watch out, Tusky! Vassa's Mermen!
Tusky to the rescue. As we saw, Tusky did all the hard work being the decoy and everything else, but you can bet Aquaman will claim the credit. Vassa retreats, but there's no time to ponder.
Uh-oh, trouble in Atlantis.
Aquaman! Aquaman!
That's Mira!
Atlantis is under attack by the Black Manta. He's firing strange colored bubbles that burst into flame. Hurry, please!
I've discussed this before. As long as there's a steady oxygen source, stuff can burn underwater. We can assume Black Manta's globules are like gunpowder. They have their own internal oxygen. It's not the fire that leaves me asking questions. Tusky has a slightly different idea about the globules.
How are we gonna beat these gas things?
Tusky's got the answer. Now I'll need some undersea jugglers.
He said jugglers, not juggalos. Three dolphins appear, start catching the globules and throwing them back at Manta's ship. While they're doing that, Aqualad leads an army of fish to deal with the fires on the dome. Remember how I said the fire wasn't what has me asking questions? That has me asking questions. If the stuff he was shooting at the dome has its own oxygen source, how does blowing it out work? Answer, it shouldn't. The dolphins are pounding Manta's ship with his own bombs, and when Aquaman comes along and starts pelting it with his water balls too, it's time to retreat.
Let's trail them. There's the Manta, the whale, and the Brain ship too.
Holy haddock! What a trio!
Ah, there they are. Stand by and see how the Brain succeeds where you two failed.
You get the feeling he was expecting them to fail, but he may regret rubbing their noses in it. It was nice of him to swim right into the trap so Brain thinks he has a chance.
My process crystallizes the salt in the water. In moments, Right before your eyes, Aquaman will be entombed in a rock of salt.
Salt is naturally crystalline, so crystallizing it amounts to letting it dry. And once he's encased in a rock of salt, all someone has to do is toss it in the water, the salt dissolves, and he's free. As brilliant diabolical plans go, the only thing I can say about this one is, you've got to be kidding. And he forgot about something. He forgot Aquaman can do that. Manta and Vassa both warned him that if he failed, that would happen. It's like the Bible says, pride goeth before a big kaboomoth.
We must get Manta before he gets us! Fire, tactile torpedoes!
There is no honor among thieves.
There never has been. Vassa is skedaddling out of there.
Don't touch Vassa's ship. It's a floating mine.
I wonder how he knows that. Probably because it looks tactile.
What about Black Manta and the Brain?
If they survived the explosion, they've already made their getaways. Let's head for home, Tadpole.
We know they survived because they only got hit by each other, and we saw from start to finish how effective their weapons are. See, this works like a soap opera. If you didn't actually see the body, they're not dead and they will be back. At least in this show, they're not likely to come back looking like a totally different person. Whatever. Okay. Three-pronged attack. Okay, I can make a three. Of course he did. That's nothing out...